brothers and sisters, keeping the peace of the Lord and the joy of the Lord within can be very difficult when we're facing a trial or a difficulty like the one we're facing right now. But the prophet Jeremiah today is giving us one clue, something very simple but very powerful, that can help us to actually recover the peace that is kind of like being stolen from us. See what is going on with him. In Jeremiah chapter 20, the word of God says, "All those who were my friends are on the watch for any misstep of mine. Perhaps he will be trapped. Then we can prevail and take our vengeance on him." Just imagine what the prophet Jeremiah can be going through. Probably fear, anxiety, anger, disappointment, discouragement, hopelessness. All of those things can be happening in the heart of the prophet. However, he decides to move his mind and his heart to another direction. See what he says immediately after that. He says, "But the Lord is with me like a mighty champion. My persecutors will stumble, they will not triumph. To you I have entrusted my cause. Sing to the Lord, praise the Lord." You see, from a moment of distress where the peace is going away, then he moves to trust in the Lord and to remember that he is with him. And now he's even saying, praise the Lord, sing to the Lord. Now there's joy coming from his heart. What caused him to move from this place to this other place? Well, I believe he remembered that when he was called for the very first time to be a prophet and a mission was entrusted to him, he remembered that there was also a promise attached to it. If we go to Jeremiah chapter 1 verse 8, the word of God says, "Do not be afraid of them, for I am with you to deliver you, oracle of the Lord." See, the Lord called him but gave him a promise. Don't be afraid. I am with you to protect you. And Jeremiah remembered that promise. He believed in that promise, and he decided to move his mind and his heart from the distress to a level of trust and peace and surrender, knowing that the Lord was going to help him and was going to protect him. Now, brothers and sisters, probably right now we're going through a lot of the emotions that Prophet Jeremiah was going through. Anger, frustration, discouragement, hopelessness, fear. However, I have great news for you. When you were called to be a disciple and you accepted to be a disciple of the Lord, you received a mission and a promise. The gospel in Matthew 28, 19 and 20, the word of God says, "Go therefore and make disciples to all nations." That's your mission. But then he says, "I will be with you all days till the end of the age." And this is amazing. You see, the same words he said to Prophet Jeremiah, he's now saying them to you. He will be with you. He will be with me. What does it mean? What did it mean for Prophet Jeremiah? It meant protection. It meant that he was going to give him wisdom to know what to say and what to do. It meant the peace of the Lord. You know, for the apostles, it meant even providence. Don't be concerned about what you're going to eat. It meant actually deliverance. When they were in jail, the Lord just came as a mighty champion and warrior and set them free. Brothers and sisters, and the Lord wants to do the same thing for you and for me, because we were called to a mission, but we were given a promise. What Prophet Jeremiah is teaching us is to leave all the discouragement and the negative thoughts and ideas and emotions aside, and then to do what the letter to the Hebrews says in chapter 12. Fix our eyes in Jesus, the author and perfecter of our faith. Brothers and sisters, let us trust in the Lord, because he is with us to protect us, to provide for us, to give us wisdom, to know what to do and what to say. May the Lord bless you.